Hello each and everyone, welcome to Global Online University. In today's lecture, I have shared most important MCQ on the teaching aptitude, which is really important for your upcoming exam, and this video will help you to clear your doubt about the teaching aptitude and will also help you to score more marks in the upcoming exam 2021. One more important thing I want to share with you that every day at 6 I am uploading my video on our channel, that is on the Global Online University. So do visit our channel every day at 6 and do watch my video and clear your exam. Before going ahead, I want to tell you one important thing which is really important for the one who is preparing for the upcoming NET exam 2021. Global Online University is providing you free video lecture as well as a free mock test. Now the question might came in your mind, how you can get this test? So here is the answer on your screen. To get this opportunity, just download our app Global Online University on your mobile. The second step is go inside and select UGC NET Paper 1 October. Then there you will find 2 free mock tests, 2 video lecture free and 2 notes PDF. Join our course. The fee of our course is $9.99, in which you will get full syllabus video lecture, 60 full syllabus tests, full syllabus notes and previous year paper 2011 to 2020. Students, Global Online University is providing course for the paper 1, in which you will get 60 mock tests with the detailed solution, previous year question paper with the detailed explanation from year 2011 to 2020, full syllabus notes. You can complete these notes within the 1 or 2 days and then you can attempt the test. Plus we are providing you video lecture. For the more detail you can contact on given number. Students, there is very less time and this is the best opportunity for you to crack your exam. So join our course just for ₹9.99 and achieve your dream. Now let's begin with today's lecture. Which of the following statement is true? In a given question, they ask you given which statement is a true, and the options given are motivated learner learn better than unmotivated, then is the girl learn better than boy, children learn better than adult, creative person learn better than intelligent. Here the correct answer for this question is option number A. Motivated learner learn better than unmotivated person. Here you can take example of yourself. If you are thinking that you are going to clear this exam, that means 100% you are going to clear this exam, because in your mind you have decided that you are going to clear this exam no matter what. That means you are self-motivated and nobody can stop the person who is self-motivated. And yes, we as a Global Online University are always there to motivate you and always there to help you to clear this exam. Reflective teaching is, and the options are, cyclic process of thinking about learning, linear process of thinking about learning. The third option is cyclic process of thinking about teaching, and the last option is linear process of thinking about learning. Now what is reflective teaching? Reflective teaching means a looking at what you do in the classroom, thinking about why you do it and thinking about if it work. Reflective teaching is a cyclical process because once you start to implement changes, then the reflective and the evaluative cycle begin again. So for this question, the option number C will be the correct. Reflective teaching is cyclic process of thinking about teaching. A teacher should identify what and teach accordingly. And the options given are economic condition of the student. Economic condition of a student will not matter in the teaching, because in a school or in a college, every student is treated equally. There is no such a scheme where the poor and the rich are separated and the teacher will teach them. The second option is economic condition of the parent. Again, this will be not matter here. Then is the individual differences among the parents. Individual differences among the parents, is it matter here? No. And the last option is individual differences among the student. Yes, this can be identified and teach accordingly. So for this question, the correct answer is option number B. Teacher should identify individual differences among the student and teach accordingly. It is important for the teacher to know variables such as a physical characteristic, intelligence, perception, gender, ability, learning style, which are individual differences of the learner. An effective and a productive learning teaching process can be planned by considering these individual differences of the student. The adult learner is, in a given question they ask you about the adult learner, and the options given are peer motivated, self motivated, family motivated and the society motivated. Adult learner jo hote hai wo self motivated hote hai. Adult learner come from the diverse culture background, adult responsibility and a job experience. ये जो होते हैं वो traditional path follow नहीं करते, like a post secondary education immediately after the high school. Instead, usually study the part time simultaneously with the work and family responsibility. So neither the peer nor family nor society or a caste that influence their learning. They are the self motivated, self directed and the practical. So for this question, the correct answer is option number B. Adult learner is self-motivated. Massive open online courses are, and the options are, flexible and open for the self-directed online learning designed for the mass participation. The second option is flexible and open for the teacher-directed online learning designed for a mass participation. The third option is flexible and open for the self-directed offline learning designed for the mass participation. And the last option is flexible and open for the teacher-directed offline learning designed for the mass participation. Massive Open Online Course, ये online course है, जो कि available है for the everyone to enroll. Massive Open Online Course provide an affordable online learning designed for the mass participation. It is a way to learn new skill, advance your career and deliver quality educational experience at scale. So for this question, the most appropriate answer will be option number A. Massive open online course are flexible and open for the self-directed online learning designed for the mass participation. Out of the following, which is the correct statement? In a given question, they ask you, given which statement is the correct, and the options given are teaching is a dependent process. Teaching jo hai wo dependent process hai. Then the second option is teaching is independent process. Third option is product of teaching must be learning. And the last option is learning is dependent upon teaching. Students is a dependent variable in teaching process. Students is a dependent on the teacher. He is a required to act accordingly to the planning and the organization of the teacher. Teaching activity of the teacher influence the learning of the student. For this question, the correct answer or a most appropriate answer will be option number A. The correct statement is teaching is dependent process. The question distinguish between the animal cell and a plant cell is based on which objective? In a question, they ask you, the question distinguish between animal cell and a plant cell is based on which of the following objective? And the options given are comprehension, analysis, synthetic and evaluation. Now here the comprehension means the ability to understand something or your actual understanding of the something. The second is analysis. Analysis is the process of breaking a difficult topic or a complex topic into the smaller part in order to gain a better understanding of that particular topic. Then is the synthesis, a combination of a component or the element to form a connected whole. And the last is evaluation. Evaluation is the assessment of the design, implementation or a result of initiative for the purpose of learning or a decision making. So for this question, the correct answer is the option number B. The question distinguish between animal cell and a plant cell is based on analysis objective. What is the best use of internet in teaching? In a given question, they ask you the best use of internet in the teaching. And the options given are for presenting content through the audio video media, in order to present a content or a subject through the audio video, we use the internet. The second is for providing latest information. Through the internet, the teacher can provide the latest information to the student. थर्ड ऑप्शन इज फॉर सेविंग टाइम एंड द एनर्जी ऑफ द टीचर. इन ऑर्डर टू सेव द एनर्जी एंड द टाइम ऑफ द टीचर वी यूज द इंटरनेट, और फॉर मेकिंग लर्निंग इंटरेक्टिव. टू मेक अ लर्निंग इंटरेक्टिव वी यूज द इंटरनेट इन द टीचिंग. टीचर कैन ऑल्सो मेक अ यूज ऑफ अ इंटरनेट बाय प्रोवाइडिंग अ स्टूडेंट विद द एक्स्ट्रा स्टडी मटेरियल एंड रिसोर्सेज सच एज अ इंटरेक्टिव लेसन, एजुकेशनल क्विज. टीचर कैन रिकॉर्ड देयर लेक्चर एंड प्रोवाइड इट टू द स्टूडेंट फॉर अ रिविजन विच इज अ बेटर रीडिंग फ्रॉम द नोट्स. हियर यू कैन से ऑल द पॉइंट्स आर करेक्ट, बट द मोस्ट अप्रोप्रिएट आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन वी कैन से इज ऑप्शन नंबर बी. वी यूज द इंटरनेट फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग द लेटेस्ट इंफॉर्मेशन. द मेन पर्पज ऑफ इंक्लूडिंग प्रैक्टिकल वर्क इन द करिकुलम इज, इन अ गिवन क्वेश्चन दे आस्क यू, प्रैक्टिकल वर्क जो होता है उसका मेन पर्पज क्या होता है इन करिकुलम में. एंड द ऑप्शन गिवन आर रिड्यूसिंग अवर एम्फोसिस ऑन द थियोरी, डेवलपिंग वेरियस स्किल इन द स्टूडेंट, हेल्पिंग स्टूडेंट टू स्कोर बेटर इन द एग्जामिनेशन, एंड कीपिंग स्टूडेंट एंगेज थ्रू आउट अ ईयर. Many students learn from easily by actually doing. That means when we do a practical thing, we learn easily. If for example, for the paper 1, you have a mathematical reasoning unit for which you cannot only read or you cannot only the listen. You have to do actual practice. Then only you will understand each and every topic easily or clearly. And that will help you for your exam. The main purpose including the practical work in the curriculum is developing various skills in the student. When you are solving the problem of mathematics unit, that means you are developing skill of solving the problem. Which of the following guarantee better retention? In a given question, they ask you, which of the following is a guarantee better retention? And the options given are use of visual aid by a teacher. The second option is active participation of the student. The third option is use of relevant example. And the last option is meaningful learning experience. Experience does make differences in a teacher effectiveness as it offers a teacher the opportunity to grow professionally by learning from the practice. This growth is a part of a learning curve that novice teacher experience as they begin their transformation into competent teacher. Here the correct answer for this question is option number D. Meaningful learning experience guarantee better retention. Before winding up for the lecture, I want to tell you one more important thing. Students, Global Online University is offering course for the NetSet exams. Iske detail aapke saamne hi hai. We are providing these courses only for ₹999. To join, please contact on given number, or you can also download our app where you will find the free trials. Students, we are providing key for your success. So do join and achieve your target.